Good morning, agents, and welcome to another daily episode of Targeted Loot today for September 1st, the series that shows you the Targeted Loot map, farming tips and tricks, and much more. I'm Agent Shadow, and if you enjoy my content, please consider smashing the subscribe and like buttons below, and check out the video description for all named gear and weapons list. Also, check out the pinned comment below for the Discord link and how to join the Shadow Crew clan on PC, Xbox, and PS4. Thanks, agents. So let's get started with the Dark Zones first and the highlights from the Dark Zone vendors this week, then DC, then New York last. So starting off in DZ West, we do have the Virginian, and then in DZ South, we have the Strategic Alignment, and then in DZ East, we have the New Reliable. And the only thing I probably would get is the New Reliable and the Virginian, of course. If you'd like to see it, it's rolled all right. It's at least over half on everything, and it does have damage to targets out of cover, which you want on anything, so that's always good. I would probably just reroll that rifle damage to 15%, and it's a pretty good Virginian, to be honest. I'm probably going to buy it, actually. Just go ahead and buy it. All right, so starting with the Dark Zones that you can actually farm for, mostly the DZ exclusives is what I mean by this segment. Chest pieces at DZ West. You can farm for the tardigrade. It does drop here. But for the DZ exclusives, what you want to farm for is the Ferocious Calm with Perfect Overwatch, and then the Door Kicker's Knock with Perfect Spark. Both of those are absolutely amazing chest pieces. I would definitely recommend farming for them. DZ South, it's not really anything. It's Seska. There's no DZ exclusive that comes off the top of my mind. But if you do know, comment in the comment section below, please. And then DZ East, we got Walker Harris & Co. And like the thumbnail shows, the Matador, that's always worth getting. And I still believe it's a DZ exclusive. I still haven't confirmed it for sure, but I've never gotten it in the light zone except for targeted loot rewards for completing an activity. Remember, it has that perfect adrenaline rush, and you can get a lot of bonus armor from that. I always recommend running that over just adrenaline rush on any other backpack. All right, agents, well, highlights for the north side now. We got chest pieces at Camp White Oak. If you want to farm for the tardigrade chest piece, exotic chest piece, I would definitely farm for it. This is pretty much a must-have when you're in a group. It's not a must-have, but it's great to have, because every time anyone in the group loses their armor bar, everyone in the group gets 100% bonus armor back, and I think that happens every 55 seconds or so. I'm not exactly sure on the time, but it does happen quite a bit. Araldo Holdings at Coney Island Ballpark. That's always great with a perfect headhunter build. I always run three pieces, aces and eights, and then Araldo Holdings two pieces, and then one piece of that Walker Harris & Co. Perfect Headhunter chest piece. Petrol Defense at the amusement park. If you're looking for contractor's gloves, that's pretty decent to farm for. I would farm here instead of gloves, actually. And then for backpacks at Manning National Zoo, I always recommend farming the brand, not the type. But if you just want to try it out, you can. Like I say, it's always better to get the brand than the type, because the brands are only a certain amount. That's not that many. Like, say, the backpacks, all six types, it's just not worth it to farm for six different brands, six different types. It's not worth it to farm for, in my opinion. If you want like a Petrov backpack, farm Petrov. All right, guys, well, let's start off with the highlights for the west side. We got Golan gear at West End. Remember, that's great with one piece for a four Eclipse Protocol build with Imperial Dynasty or the Vile Mask. I have a build on that, and I'll show it in the top right card. And then, of course, Providence Defense at Downtown West. You got a few control points to farm here, and their manhunts as well. You can get the sacrifice with Perfect Glass Cannon. And then, of course, anyone that has DPS builds will know they can always get a better backpack that's like Providence with Vigilance, with all red rolls for critted chance, critted damage, and weapon damage. You know, something like that. You're always going to be looking for something a little bit better in the rolls department. You can farm Golan gear at Constitutional Hall as well if you don't want to farm it at West End. This one does have three control points, and this one also has three control points, so it's up to you. And don't forget the bounties as well. There's bounties everywhere, and they're definitely worth farming for. You got Grupo Sombro at Foggy Bottom. Remember, you always run one piece for your DPS builds, 15% crit hit damage. But you run two pieces for your skill, explosive skill damage builds, because of that 15% explosives damage. And then you got masks at the Potomac Event Center. So that's the Coyote's Mask, which is almost always mandatory for DPS builds unless you're, you know, going beyond the 15 meters to get that 25% crit hit damage for you and your allies. and then you can refarm the vial mask and the punch drunk mask with 20% headshot damage baked into it. It's a Douglas and Harding mask. Pistols at Roosevelt Island, and let's go over the legendaries this week too. We got gear sets at District Union Arena and skill attachments at Capitol Building. Nothing really that great. I mean, you know, farming for gear sets isn't really that difficult, you know, because you only really need to reroll one thing on it usually, especially if it's skill tier. But I don't know, sometimes it actually does matter. Like Foundry Bulwark, you want a maxed out armor roll, so I would run legendary at District Union today if you need some god rolls on your Foundry Bulwark, or you know, something that doesn't roll skill tier. And then Honeyu at Tidal Basin, you can get the Force Multiplier backpack with perfect combined arms. That is always worth farming for, and it's always worth farming for one that has skill haste, skill damage, so you can reroll the utility mod slot, which is going to be going away with TU11, and I believe there's a state of the game tomorrow, so tune in for that as well, and I'll probably do a recap on that if you guys want me to. Comment in the comment section below if you guys want me to do recaps like that, and I will. And then Richter and Kaiser is great for those healer builds usually. And then, of course, rifles at the Pentagon. So you always want to try to get a classic M1A, or if you're interested in M1A CQB, which is actually more powerful. It's just a little bit harder to control. And the best talents for those damage-wise is always Boomerang, which is on the Virginia, and it has perfect Boomerang, and it's amazing. Now, that also returns a bullet to your magazine and gives you like 40% increased damage when it does return it. So it's really powerful. Otherwise, I would always recommend Ranger, especially on missions like Roosevelt Island, where it's longer range most of the time. And then, of course, Rifleman, if you can consistently land headshots, and the Baker's Dozen, which is something a lot of console users that I know of really are looking for all the time. And then, of course, the Diamondback and Merciless are wonderful to get as well. I actually have a build that can utilize the Merciless with Braced as the chest talent to calm it down while you're in cover shooting. You might want to check that out as well. Overlord for the Fox's Prayer knee pads, that has 8% damage to targets out of cover. And like I said earlier, damage to targets out of cover is multiplicative damage, and it's the strongest thing in this game. It's more important than crit hit damage. You always want to add damage to targets out of cover on Fox's Prayer knee pads and on your weapons for just max damage that you can get. Wyvernware for that 10% skill damage. If you can get a Wyvernware chest piece with like spotter, or kinetic momentum, or glass cannon, keep it for sure. And you always usually want skill haste and skill damage on most of that stuff. And then yeah, that's pretty much it for over here. If you're looking for a good MMR, I always recommend the White Death and then the Elk's Long Stick, which has perfect ranger on it. Both of those are really top tier. And you can also refarm the Nemesis and the Mantis exotic MMRs as well. Alright agents, well let's go ahead and get started with the east side. So, gear sets at District Union, like I said before. You can farm Foundry Bulwark, and you can farm for the Future Initiative pieces. Just, you can't get the chest and backpack pieces yet. They're still locked behind the raid as raid exclusives. But that will eventually go away, like Negotiator's Dilemma backpack and chest piece went away. So, be on the lookout for that. I'll let you guys know when that happens. And then, of course, you can always farm for anything else except for System Corruption, which is a DZ exclusive, but very well worth it for those two-piece bonus set of having that armor on kill. Circle of Concern, if you're running an SMG, always run this over Providence Defense because it also gives you crit hit damage and crit hit chances, the brand bonuses, and that 10% SMG damage as well. Badger Tough for that 0F's chest piece with Perfectly Unbreakable. I love that chest piece. If you can get an armor roll with all crit hit chance, crit hit damage, and a red mod slot, that is very, very well worth it. I have one actually on my Shredder build, and I love that build so much. Honeyu again, but in East Mall, you got 4 control points to farm, and these are all manhunts as well, which I'm actually trying to complete right now for that garbage repair trap. And then Alp Summit's great for a healer build, which I should be dropping pretty soon. I have this best build series that I'm working on, and definitely comment in the comment section below if you're looking forward to that. Because I'm trying to give you guys the best DPS builds I have, the best status effects builds, skill damage builds, explosives builds, all that good stuff. So I hope you guys are excited for that. Assault Rifles at Jefferson Plaza. You can get the Mechanical Animal, the Chameleon Exotic. You can get the Burnout named FAMAS, the Maniac. That's the named military AKM, which is my favorite gun in the game. Not the Maniac, but the military AKM is absolutely amazing. I can get over 1.3 million body shots and crits with that thing with my Focus Vigilance build. It's insane. And then, of course, the top tier assault rifles would be the Military AKM, the FAMAS, the Carbine 7, Police M4, P416 variants. All that stuff is amazing. Really good to run with. They're the best assault rifles in the game. And then SMGs at Space Administration. So that's Lady Death, refarming the Chatterbox. And if you guys need help refarming the Chatterbox, I got a build video on that as well that you can check out. It's really quick, about 5.5 minutes long. It's worth checking out just to get a reminder if you don't know. And then, of course, the best SMGs that you can get are the Vector variants, the MPX, and the MP5. And then gloves at Southwest. If you know about my No Hope Hotel XP farm, I would run that today if you need BTSU gloves and or contractor's gloves. You'll definitely get it if you're just refarming that control point every 6 minutes. That's definitely going to be a easier way to get it today for sure. And those BTSU gloves are part of one of my healer builds, so I would definitely want to check that out as well. All right, agents, let's go ahead and just check out what we got in New York City as targeted loot before I let you guys go. All right, guys, so like I said on the thumbnail, well, like it shows on the thumbnail, we got LMGs at Wall Street today. So if you're looking for that Bullet King, farm it today. If you're looking for a better Bullet King and you can't reconfigure it because you don't have exotic components or enough of them, refarm it today at the Wall Street. This is the main source of getting a Bullet King because it's a Riker's mission. That means that the Riker's bosses at the end have a chance to drop it. You can run it on heroic or challenging, and this is how it really is, guys, with the heroic challenging thing. Because you can get a really good rolled exotic on story mode. I've gotten my Ninja Bike Messenger knee pads completely god rolled on story mode. Because on my fourth alt, I was doing Manning National Zoo. And guess what? I hadn't finished it yet on story mode, so I just blazed through it. Halfway through it, I got the Ninja Bike Messenger knee pads to drop because exotics don't care about difficulty. Now, if you can run, let's say, just decide every hour that you farm Wall Street, how many times can you complete it on heroic and how many times can you complete it on challenging? If you can complete Wall Street on challenging quicker than you can complete it on heroic per hour, then that is the difficulty you need to decide on when you're farming any exotic. And make sure it's only exotics, because the loot will degrade in quality once you get down to challenging. It'll be something, if you're min-maxing, you won't be able to use pretty much any of the loot. And then knee pads at Financial District. Remember, Ninja Bike Messenger knee pads, Fox Hesperia knee pads, and Sawyer's knee pads all are definitely worth it. I have builds for all three. Definitely check them out and also grab those Fox Hesperia knee pads. Shotguns at Pathway Park for that Sweet Dream exotic shotgun. Also, I love the Marine Super 90 and also the custom M870 are the top tier shotguns in my opinion. Well, actually not my opinion, they are just the best. And then holsters at Stranded Tanker, that's the main source for the Imperial Dynasty. So we got two things today, like LMGs at Wall Street and holsters at Stranded Tanker. Both of these are the main sources of the Imperial Dynasty and the Bullet King. So they're super easy to get today, and I highly recommend getting them. I have a build with the Imperial Dynasty on it, and I don't even like changing it to the Vial. I prefer the Imperial Dynasty. Please check that out. Please get that Imperial Dynasty if you don't have it. It's well worth it for sure. And then, of course, you can farm all this other stuff in DC or in New York City. That is all personal preference. All right, agents. Well, that was the targeted loot today. Thank you for watching, and be sure to subscribe and like if you enjoyed my content. Go ahead and click the join button below for further support of my dream being a full-time content creator, and check out the Discord and clan in the pinned comment section below. Take care, agents, and be sure to stay tuned for more daily videos and much more. This is Agent Shadow signing off. I will see you in the next video.